We're the St. Louis Ragtimers, and we're from St. Louis, Missouri, and that's how we came up with that original name. That's all we could think of. But we've been together since Labor Day of 61 as a band, and the nice part is we got the four original guys that were in the band when we started. So will the four originals raise your hand? Jingle had a lover, he was always undercover. Every night she used to meet him, oh how nice she used to treat him. So they eloped, but they both were collared. Then the gang stood up and hollered, don't you raise a fuss, or you gotta take one of us. Well, oh, ba-ka, gosh, ba-gee-ba-ja, won't you listen to our tale of love? We will build for you a hut. You will be our favorite nut. We'll have a lot of little old bagongs, and we'll put them in the follies. Oh, bagongs, set up, bagash, bagee. Oh, by Jiminy, please don't bother me. And so they all went away singing, oh, bagongs, bagash, bagee. Oh, by Jiminy, you're the only gal for me. This is a ragtime tune that was written by Tom Turpin of St. Louis, Missouri. He was a black piano player, composer, saloon owner, gunfighter. He did just about everything. Card player, right, and lived till 1922, beside. So this is a number he had published in 1897, a very early ragtime tune called the Harlem Rag. Thank you.
Okay, a little blind boon here, huh? Right. This is a tune that dates to 1909. It was published in Columbia, Missouri, written by a blind piano player, John W. Blind Boone. He was a black man. He was a concert pianist, toured the world, played the classics. But he played ragtime in his concerts as well. So this is a collection of Negro folk tunes that he put all together in one package and had it published in Columbia in 1909. So this is called Blind Boone's Southern Rag Medley Number 2, or Strains from Flat Branch. Take your choice.
Okay, Trebor.
1915, this next tune came out, written by Henry Marshall and Mr. Stanley Murphy. This was called Loading Up to Mandy Lee.
Bam. One, two.
that great big crowd on the levee today, all feeling gay, counting their pay. Good ship Mandy Lee is loaded up with the cotton, corn, and sugar cane. All the gals are dressed in their Sunday best, calico, red, white, and blue. Everybody's dancing to a Dixie tune. Can't you hear them calling you? Come on down, come on down. It's going to be a jubilee in Natchez Town. Honey dear, can't you hear Miss Melinda at the window calling out for Miss Corinda? Come on to the barbecue. That's where every darky's got to be. He'll be dancing with his honey, pocket full of money after loading up the Mandy Lee. Jefferson, the big leader man, stick out his hand because he's leading the band. Honey, when they start to play the Memphis blues, you'll surely shake your shoes. Miss Mariah Johnson's gonna ball the jack. She'll show you something that's new. Think of all the spooning when we're coming back. That's the time. And you, so won't you come on down, come on down. Wind to be a jubilee in Natchez Town. Honey dear, can't you hear Miss Melinda at the window calling out for Miss Clorinda? Come on to that barbecue. That's where every darky's gotta be. Why, he'll be dancing with his honey, pocket full of money after loading up the Mandy Lee.
Yeah. Thank you. Thanks.
Here's one of the ragtime compositions of Joe Lamb. He was from Montclair, New Jersey, and along with James Scott and Scott Joplin, he was considered one of the top three composers of classic rags. But this one is a little more on the lighthearted side that he wrote back around 1910, right in there. This was called Champagne Rag.
Thank you.
Champagne for everybody. All right, there's a ragtime song from the year 1900. I believe a fellow named Gene Jefferson wrote this, and somebody asked me, Al, can you ever make $1 million playing ragtime? And the answer is no, but you can live in genteel poverty. But anyway, here's a number from 1900 called I'm a Ragtime Millionaire.
Okay, Trevor, you bring the first one in. Here we go. Key of C. One, two, one, two.
I got money to burn, I got money to spare. Slipping through the expensive world with ease. I'm gonna die with the money disease. I'm a ragtime millionaire. More popular than the man in the president's chair. Rich men in town tipped their head off to me. I'm a ragtime millionaire. Money to burn, I got money to spare. Slipping through the expensive world with ease. I'm gonna die with the money disease. I'm a ragtime millionaire. More popular than the man in the president's chair. Rich men in town tipped their hat off to me. I'm a ragtime millionaire. Our friend Ernie Carson, who's out there somewhere. Thank you.
Okay. Sentimental Gentleman from Georgia.
Oh, yeah.
Sentimental Gentleman from Georgia.
All right, here's a nice old tune that Isham Jones originally recorded, and then the Boswell sisters came along with it later on. It's a snappy, nice little tune. Called A Sentimental Gentleman from Georgia. Here we go, gents. One, two, one, two, three. gentleman from Georgia, Georgia, gentle to the ladies all the time. Why, when it comes to loving, he's a real professor. Yes, sir, just a Mason-Dixon Valentine. Well, just you see those Georgia peaches hanging around him now. 'Cause what his daddy teaches, nobody else knows how. That sentimental gentleman from Georgia, Georgia, gentle to the ladies all the time. Teaches, nobody else knows how. That sentimental gentleman from Georgia, Georgia, gentle to the ladies all the time. A nice little ragtime march that we'd like to do. It was written by Scott Joplin in 1904, published in Sedalia, Missouri by the Perry Music Company. I guess it was one of the few things that Perry published by Joplin, but it's a rather obscure number. It has some nice little syncopated things going on in it, so we'd like to do it for you. This is called The Favorite.
Thank you.
Here's a little ragtime, the favorite. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Last night on the back porch. Last night. PSC band.
Here's a tune from 1923. The composers were Lou Brown and Carl Schraubstater. How's that for name dropping? But that was his name. But this was probably the only big hit song Carl Schraubstater ever wrote. But it was a nice popular tune in its day.
Little C band, Peter. One.
There's a girl I'm wild about. Every time I take her out, I scurry, I hurry, I worry so. I'm afraid that I might see someone there in place of me. And if I lost her, what a blow. I love her so, whoa, 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 whoa. I love her in the morning, and I love her at night. I love her, yes, I love her, when the stars are shining bright. I love her in the springtime, I love her in the fall. But last night on the back porch, I loved her best of all. Someone there in place of me. And if I lost her, what a blow. I love her so, whoa, 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 whoa. I love her in the morning, and I love her at night. I love her, yes, I love her, when the stars are shining bright. I love her in the parlor, I love her in the hall. But last night on the back porch, I loved her best of all. Monday until Sunday, I sure am a chic. I love her, yes, I love her, every day that's in the week. And those 7 days of heaven ain't enough, I won't get sore. In a few years, when it's leap year, I'm gonna love her one day more. Another ragtime number, this one by Mr. Tom Turpin, St. Louis, and as we stated earlier, wrote Harlem Rag in 1897. Well, 6 years later, 1903, he wrote this tune for the World's Fair in St. Louis in 1904. Now, the reason he was a year early was because they ran out of money. The fair was supposed to open in 1903, but they didn't have enough money to do it. So they, believe it or not, they got a federal loan in those days to complete it. Of course, it has never stopped. But anyway, here's a tune from that era called St. Louis Rag.
Trebor.
Sound for Trebor at the keyboard. All right, we did a blues tune earlier, seems like a week ago, but we had a request for it when we came in earlier. It was called Apex Blues. It's a very nice tune. It was done by the brilliant clarinet player Jimmy Noon from New Orleans. He played up in Chicago at the Apex Club, so they titled this tune after that spot. So for those of you that have heard it before, please bear with us because this does happen. Sometimes you repeat tunes. So this is it, Apex Blues.
We weren't there a week ago.
It seemed like a week ago. You lose track of time when you're at these festivals.
That's good. It means you enjoy yourself.
That's right, yeah, right. Okay, ready, fellas?
One, two. Thank you.
How about a nice hand for Eric Sager and Bill Mason? Well, here's a prison tune for those of you that got out. But one of the better recordings done by years ago, believe it or not, was done by Andy Griffith. You know, that when he used to have Denver Pyle and all of those guys on that show, they did a record of this tune, and this was it. This is fun to play, called the Midnight Special. Of course, Lead Belly did it, you know, many years ago, too.
B flat, okay.
Yonder comes a Miss Rosie. How in the world do you know? I tell her by apron and the clothes she wore. Umbrella on her shoulder, piece of paper in her hand. She going to get the governor to turn her loose her man. On the midnight special, shine a light on me. Let the midnight special just shine the devil of a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special just shine the devil of a light on me. That sheriff, he'll grab you, and the boys will take you down. The judge is gonna tell you you're sugar land bound. On the midnight special, shine a light on me. Let the midnight special come shine the devil of a light on me. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight special just shine the devil of a light on me. Nothing in your pan. You better not complain, Lord. You get in trouble with that man. We'll be right back. prison style.
Thank you.
Okay, so that's that wrap then? Okay, set bust.
All right, here's a Tiny Palm number. Tiny Palm was from Kansas City, Missouri, but he made some great hot recordings, and most of them done up in Chicago. So this is for all the beer drinkers in the house. This is called a Sudbuster's Dream.
Ready?
For your kind attention. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Very kind. Thank you, sir. Thanks, folks.
Thank you very much, and enjoy yourselves while you're here. We're having a good time.